We're just about to push the car out onto the street. The car's got no engine in it, so obviously here's bits and bobs of the engine.
Just about to push the car out in the street, so I've got somewhere to live for the next week. I guess I'm going to be stuck for another week. So the parts arrived today. Built, and hopefully, hopefully by Friday. It is now Saturday, so hopefully by Thursday, Friday, can be all day.
Today, taking out the gearbox before we push it across the street, so I can go and live in it. We're getting there, slowly but surely. We are getting there.
I've got itchy feet now.
Right, gearbox is out, differential's out, so. There's not a lot of mechanics still left in the car. The car is basically a shell now. The engine's out, the gearbox out. I mean, the car's being rebuilt. So, you know, this gentleman actually learned on a car in the 1970s where he learned how to do mechanics. So this car's more or less the sort of car he learned on. Looking at another 10 days.
This one here, I'm gonna try to get rid of these joints. These joints are looking a bit fucked actually. So I think I've been another new part. I mean, the car is almost gonna be mechanically new in a sense. Which is, I guess, a positive thing.
Another very noticeable difference with having no Andy is the car is a lot more spacious on the inside. So, another positive. Good for my head, good for my body.
This is the differential. What I've realised is this is going to be the greatest opportunity for me to learn how to build this car. So, I've said to Theo on Monday, I'd like to help. So whatever he wants me to do, cleaning the parts, whatever, it doesn't matter. But I want to be involved in the rebuild. And that will also be a situation where, you know, if something goes wrong in the future, then at least I've got a bit more of a chance to understand what is going wrong. Because an amazing opportunity for me to learn about mechanics as quickly as I can, because I'm going to rebuild my own motor with Theo. So that's going to be just fucking tip top. A silver lining to every cloud, no matter how dark the cloud is. And this is a pretty dark cloud. I mean, I'm stuck here for another 7 days, but if we do 7 days in the workshop with Theo, fucking great, fantastic. Okay, big day today. This is my first day at work to rebuild the car. So the parts, hopefully, well, we've been told arrive tomorrow, but you know, there's a lot of stuff to be done. I mean, you know, literally there is no mechanics in this car anymore. It's all been taken out. So I guess time to get the hands dirty. I'll clean everything. So
long day.
And over here, they do lunch for 2 hours a day. So, you know, while he's at lunch, I said, listen, while you're at lunch, just, I will keep cleaning. I'll keep doing whatever needs to be done because I need to get going. So hopefully, fingers crossed, this week, maybe this week.
When I was a little boy,
I used to spend months of the year, about 3 or 4 months of the year with my grandparents, school holidays and stuff. And I used to spend hours and hours a day in the workshop with my grandfather. He was an engineer in the Second World War. And it's exactly what's happening right now. You know, being with Theo was like being with my grandfather. And it's really reminded me of really fond memories of the time I spent with my grandfather. And I guess Theo's clearly a bit younger than my grandfather, or was. But of that same sort of generation of man, and it's really wonderful. I'm absolutely loving it. I mean, I've got hands dirty, cleaning all the parts, learning about transmission, and it's put a real smile on my face. In fact, you know, I was starting to get a little bit despondent because the parts haven't arrived yet from Santiago. Things are very slow here, and I was getting very despondent about how long it's going to take. But now I'm sort of working and learning. The time's not such an importance anymore. I mean, I will sort of stay in the workshop until things are done.
It's my first day at work, and today I'm going to be cleaning these parts and all the parts, getting all the shit off them, getting them all clean. The parts, hopefully, the spares hopefully arrive tomorrow. Differential is completely taken apart, so we are literally cleaning everything up. It's going to look like a brand new motor, so I am fucking pumped.
Right, transmission's apart. It's good. I'm busy cleaning all these bits and pieces, getting everything ready to be reassembled. I mean, obviously, that, you know, they don't look brand new, but they certainly look a lot better than they used to. But we are slowly getting there. It's like a jigsaw puzzle.
You know, he's sort of teaching me and showing me stuff, and I feel like I'm being useful, which is great. So, absolutely, like, I'm happy as pig in shit. The world never seen.
soon. Ever meet the midnight rambler.
Right, Mateo, and we are heading off to go and get the engine block. The parts have arrived, so today, hopefully, we're going to make some serious progress.
Right, I'm at the place where the engine blocks have been done.
Okay, I'm waiting. Now I'm getting excited. Now all of a sudden, it's starting to happen. Well, after my first day of work, which I have to say I loved, as I touched on before, it was like spending time with my grandfather. I mean, he's such a great guy, and we're managing to communicate with my sort of Spanglish, and he's, well, Spanish, he doesn't have any English. We're getting there.
And
what is it? Today's Tuesday. Hopefully, by, I'd like to think by Sunday, I can leave.